Okay. Here we have an early eBay Christmas present to me, from me. And this obviously is first look. I'm literally unboxing it. So here we go. And yes, the box actually does contain what it, or I hope it contains what it says on the box, which is a Sony PS-FL77 turntable. So let's have a look. So far, looking good. Plenty of padding. Yeah, excellent. And they've actually packed the platter separately. It's in the bottom of the box. Along with the rubber mat, which is superb. Okay. So, there we go. Let's zoom in on that a bit. Okay, now I'm a big fan of the Sony PSFL range of turntables. I already have a Sony PSFL3, which is a much lower spec model than this, but this, the PSFL77, this is the one. This actually has a BioTracer linear tracking arm, and is pretty much the top of the range model that they made at the time. And the beauty of course of these decks is they are front loading, so this tray here slides out, you pop the record on and it slides back in again, and it's great if you happen to have a hi-fi stack or something where you just or simply don't have the space for a normal conventional turntable. Now this one has a few issues. Apparently doesn't it powers up, but the arm doesn't move, and there's a rather nasty crack in the top of the case here, but other than that it does seem to be the front is obviously loose. It does actually seem to be in reasonably good condition. Big crunch on the side here, but yeah. So that's going to be a Christmas project, I think, to see whether we can get this running. So keep watching. Okay, well there's the Sony PSFL77 with the cover off, and I was very, very lucky with this one. Basically all the problems were mechanical damage. There was no electrical, as far as I can tell, or electronic problems with it at all. This door here attaches via a screw on this side and a screw on that side to these arms, which it just lowers down into this slot. There's a slot in the front which you can't quite see. And one side was fine, the other side the plastic had broken completely, so I'm hoping there's enough left of the plastic to epoxy it onto the arm. There's no weight or anything to this, and it's not under any stress, so I'm kind of hoping that will be okay. The worst damage was with the lid. There was a in the first part there was a terrible sort of crack all the way down here, which I've now glued, and then let's put it this way around. What I've done is I've reinforced the back piece is cracked off completely here. I've glued that back on, and I've reinforced it with a very thin piece of sheet brass, which is being currently epoxied in place. So that's basically what was wrong with the lid. I'm hoping those repairs will be sufficient. There was another problem with this. I'll see if I can zoom in on it. I don't know whether this will focus on that. How much of that you can see. The speed select button, which is this button here, when I first powered it up, it was stuck on 45 and I couldn't get it to change. And basically, someone had pushed this in really, really hard and dented the plastic, flexible plastic overlay here. So basically, it was holding the button that is on the printed circuit board behind there permanently down. So I was able to take this all apart and push this back out again, thus freeing the button up. And now the speed change works correctly. So hopefully, once all these mods are done, it will be back in full function operation. I have actually played both an LP, a 33 and a 45 record on this, and it all works fine. It tracks properly, and it all the controls on the front panel work, and the tray slides in and out perfectly okay. So I'm hoping that there is nothing else wrong with this. So fingers crossed, once the glue has had a chance to set overnight, we should have a fully functioning PS-FL77. Well, there's the repaired Sony PS-FL77. It seems to work okay. I took a slight issue with the door, which you'll see when it closes, but at least we can now change the speed from 45 to 33. Anyway, let's have a look at it. See that the door will catch when it comes to close, but I'm not too bothered about that. It's working, and obviously I can't let you hear the record because I'll immediately get a copyright strike, but what we can do is I can change the camera angle so you can actually see the tone arm in operation. So we'll just move the camera a bit for that. The top here actually obscures the main part of the tone arm, but you can just see the tone arm head there. So if I select start, you watch this. There we go. This particular record is a little bit on a slightly warped, so you can see the head moving up and down every now and again. But it's playing fine. So, yeah, looking good. Yeah, here we have the deck with the door fully open, and you can actually better see the tone arm and its track in this position. It's kind of strange, the front end of the tone arm is sort of like fully floating, which is kind of weird, but it works, apparently works very well. All I've got to do now is hook it up to my system and see what it sounds like. Well, there it is in the rack. It does seem to look a little bit lost in that space, but this particular stack here was built specifically to house Laserdisc players, so obviously they're considerably bigger than the turntable. I thought we'd demonstrate it, and I believe I actually have an LP record which won't get a copyright strike from YouTube due to the fact that it is very old, and the track we're going to play is Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies, which is on YouTube's audio library as free to use. So let's open the door. Yeah, I've also managed to fix the door. After watching it open and close a few times, I realised that what happened was that the two metal arms that hold this smoked Perspex front here, the little door, had got shifted slightly to the right. So simply stuck a small thin piece of plastic on the edge of the mount where the plastic here mounts to the metal arm, and that now slightly moves it across, and it now all opens and closes nicely. So there we go, let's see if it works. Right, well, this record's not the best quality, but it does play, so. Anyway, there we go. It all seems to be working very well, and you put a decent quality record on there and it actually sounds superb. So I don't think there was much wrong with it. Electrically, it was just mainly cosmetic damage. So. There you go. One resurrected Sony PS-FL77.